Since November, since late November, Ukrainians all over the world have been standing and showing their support to Euromaidan. Euromaidan is a wave of civil demonstrations against government in Ukraine. People are fighting for their basic rights, for democracy and freedom from fear. In Ukraine, it is freedom from being oppressed and harassed by police and other government employees who are rotten with corruption and greed to their bones. That's why we're standing here. That's why Euromaidan exists. Here in Canada, in Ukraine, in the heart of Ukraine, in Kiev, in East, in West, we want to show that Ukraine is not object for bidding. Ukraine cannot be sold for 15 billion, for 25 billion. This is our land. It's been soaked with blood of our ancestors. We share DNA with this land. And that is why it is our land and our right to decide what's going to be there. Ні за які гроші. І якщо в Януковича немає тієї честі, і в Путіна, то нехай вони забираються геть і лишають нам нашу землю.
Путін has got Ukraine! Путін has got Ukraine!
Путін has got Ukraine! Freedom for 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 Ukraine!
Freedom for Ukraine! Freedom for Ukraine!
Пам'ятаємо, українці, наша гордість, наша слава ще пролунає. Ми боремося і боролися завжди, і будемо боротися до кінця. Світогляд українців помінявся, він повстає і дедалі стає сильнішим. Путін забирає Януковича з собою і ховається, тому що український народ тебе знайде. Ми повсюди. Пам'ятайте великі слова великого отамана Івана Сірка. Здобудеш волю, заслужиш небо. Також пам'ятайте, що в найтяжчій боротьбі гартується найславетніша перемога. Дякую. Слава Україні!
Януковича в Москву!
Я йду від тебе і до тебе.
For example, it can say, Mr. Putin, hands off Ukraine, otherwise the G8 will exclude Russia and once again become the G7. It can say, Mr. Putin, hands off Ukraine, otherwise we will not cooperate on Syria, on Iran, on Afghanistan. It can remind Mr. Putin that at the WTO, World Trade Organization gatherings, trade wars will not be tolerated. It can remind Mr. Putin that at the OSCE gatherings, gross human rights violations will not be tolerated. It can remind Putin again and again that Russia was a signatory of the 1994 Budapest Protocols that assure Ukraine the inviolability of its sovereignty. And finally, the West can remind Putin that it will show open discomfort with Putin's Ukraine policies at all international meetings. So, what can the West do? It can do a lot, but it must have the courage to do this. Дякую, слава Україні!
Again, for all Canadians who are listening to us right now and wondering what this group of people is doing here on this particular day, Ukrainian community in Canada gathered in front of the Russian consulate right here because we do not like Russia interfering into Ukraine's internal affairs. Russian government throughout the ages in different forms, whether it's a Tsarist rule, a Communist Party rule, or right now a United Russia political party rule that was headed by Putin, they interfere into Ukraine and its affairs and try to control our politicians, but they will never control our will, our intelligence, our hearts, and they will never erase our historical memory. We will never forget our heroes, what they've done, and we will never let go everything what we achieved, which is our independence and our freedom. I want to also invite right now Mark Schweitz, who is a chair of the Euromaidan Toronto committee that we have here, for Naslova.
For Naslova.
Слава Ісусу Христу!
Слава
Україні!
Слава!
Our community is gathered here once again, and I see so many of the people that have been with us week after week standing up for Ukraine. And this week, in front of the Russian consulate here in Toronto, to tell Putin that we call upon him, his government, his cronies, to cease and desist in meddling in affairs of our maternal homeland, Ukraine. Time to get out. Time to get out. Stop interfering with Ukraine. Sergei Glayev, an advisor of his, said we were threatening to interfere in Ukraine by sending in troops. He's trying to divide East and West Ukraine. They're openly encouraging Ukrainian authorities to go to the Maidan with troops and to break it with force. They're trying to blackmail Ukraine with $15 billion, and now they won't even give it to them. They claim the Maidan has $20 million a week. If you look at the TV, if you look at pictures, do those people look like they have $20 million every week? That would have been $250 million by now flowing to the Maidan. Does it look like that? Russia is lying, Putin is lying, his advisors are lying. They want Ukraine, they want the empire back, and we say no! We say no! We say no! No! No!
No! Ukraine!
We ask the international community to stand with us to condemn Putin and his government for meddling in the affairs of Ukraine and to help Ukraine defend its territorial integrity, because Ukraine is a sovereign country. Ukraine gave up its nuclear arsenal for integrity of its lands. And what do we get now? A neighbor who's threatening Ukraine. The West, Europe, the US, Canada, and all nations need to stand up and stand up to Putin and tell him, hands off Ukraine!
Hands off Ukraine! Hands off Ukraine! Hands off Ukraine! Hands off Ukraine! Hands off Ukraine! Hands off Ukraine! Russia! Hands off Ukraine! Russia! Hands off Ukraine! Russia! Hands off Ukraine! Russia! Hands off Ukraine! Russia!
Russia! I want to be absolutely clear for everyone listening, whether live, whether on video, wherever this gets translated. And I want to make one point absolutely clear. We are not, and I repeat, not against the Russian people, because they want democracy just like we want democracy. We're against Putin. We're against his government and all those oligarchs who are destroying Russia just as they're destroying Ukraine. Because if we have democracy in Ukraine, eventually democracy will be in Russia. And Ukraine is the front line of the war of democracy. And that's why Putin wants Ukraine to break the back of the Ukrainian people. And we say to the Russian people, stand up. Rise up to the Russians. Stand up to Putin. Democracy is number one. With democracy, you will be free. Stand with the Ukrainian people, and we will stand with you. For 300 years, Russia has occupied Ukraine. For 300 years, the Ukrainian people have battled, have fought, war after war for its freedom. Ukraine declared independence and has the right to be independent. Do we have to lose more people? Ukraine lost 20 million people. No more. Ukraine lost 20 million people in the span of 20 years in World War I with the Holodomor, the famine genocide, with people going to Siberia to the gulags, and then World War II. Russia, its leaders have treated Ukraine with disdain, have trampled on Ukraine, and we will never let it happen again. And that's why we stand with the Maidan united, and we stand against Moscow, against Putin and his band of thieves and thugs that want to take over Ukraine and renew the USSR, the empire. We just simply won't let it happen. We say, Moscow, hands off Ukraine.
Moscow, hands off Ukraine. Moscow, hands off Ukraine.
As I conclude, we stand for freedom, we stand for democracy, we're against corruption, we're against corrupt oligarchs, whether that be in Kyiv or whether that be in Moscow, and even more so when they join together. Yanukovych just went to Sochi to meet with Putin to get his next instructions, and we are
shame.
And he went there to get his instructions, and they've drawn a line in the sand of the 17th of February. And we expect that after that date, the proposed so-called amnesty, which isn't really an amnesty, will end, and they will start to attack the Maidan. They're already interrogating people, threatening them. They will start using force. Russia's making announcements day after day in the newspapers. We have to stand vigilant. We have to stand with Ukraine. We have to stand united against Putin and against Moscow. Slava Ukraini!
Slava!
Slava Ukraini!
Slava!
Slava Ukraini!
Україно! Україно! Моя рідна мати! Чи ще довго над тобою будуть воювати? Чи ще кров? Чи ще довго будуть воювати, чи ще з тебе кривавицю будуть з тебе пити, і діток твоїх бідних в кайдани водити. Твоя слава у могилі, а воля в Сибирі. Ось що ж тобі, матусенько, вороги зробили? Може знову розв'яжуться зв'язані руки, може знову брешатимуть козацькі шаблюки. Може військо Запорізьке, як море заграє, а дівчина, як і перше, пісню заспіває. Тоді вже нас не заберуть ні московські внуки, бо кров за кров на кров нашу, а муки за муки. Гукне серце Україну, та тільки скоріше, бо чим рані далі просуть нашу, все більше та більше.
Дякуємо!
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 Україну!